morning and welcome. I'm Lauren Lewis with Power for Parkinson's. Welcome to Power for Parkinson's YouTube channel. We are the number one Parkinson's exercise channel, and we thank you for your support. This is a young onset circuit training class. We'll be working at a fairly high level of intensity. Please make sure that you can exercise for about an hour. We will be getting on and off the floor, so if you need some assistance with that, please make sure you have a chair. Also, I will be showing modifications for many of our exercises. You may want to use the chair to assist you in those exercises. For today's class, you'll be needing some light weights. Not necessary, but I will be including light weights. If you don't have light weights but would like to add some resistance, cans from your pantry, make sure they're the same size, but cans will work and be a great option, or water bottles are also a good option. So get yourself set, get some water, get yourself in a nice, comfortable and safe environment, and let's start warming up. All right, so we're going to warm up for about 3 minutes. Come on and join me. We're going to start with a march, nice and easy, right, left. Swing those arms a little more. We're just trying to get that heart rate up, nice and easy. Good, let's take 2 steps to the right. Oh, that's to the left, sorry. Good, let's keep going. 2 steps, just nice and easy. 2 steps. Keep going, swing those arms a little more, get that heart rate up a little higher. Let's take these 2 steps to single steps. Single steps, right, left. Change that to a heel in front. Heel in front. Keeping those arms swinging, getting the heart rate up nice and slowly and gently. Let's bring those arms a little higher. And a little higher. Bring it back to a march. Let's take it to a gentle and modified jack, right, left. Bend your knees, go right and left, right, center, left, right, center, left, right, center, left. 4 more. 3, 2, that's getting your heart rate up, yes? Good, now we're gonna do doubles each side. 2 right. 2 left. Stay with me. 2 right. 2 left. Good. Let's change this to 4 each side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Switch. Again. Take it back to 2s. Again. Single counts, jacks. Now if you want to take this to a full jack, right here, good for you. Jump or do not jump, your choice. Modified jack is right here. All right, let's add some knee lifts. Ready? Lift that knee nice and high, warming up the hamstrings and glutes. Get a little more intense by bending down a little lower. Let's take this to a gentle kick. Warming up those hamstrings just a little more. Lengthening those hamstrings. Push away, use those arms. Let's go for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Give me doubles, double each side. 2 right, 2 left. Right, left. Back to singles for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, back to knee lifts. We're gonna take that heart rate down just a little now that we've got it up. Good, and to a march. Inhale up, arms overhead. You never wanna just stop. You wanna get that heart rate down slowly and carefully. Nice work, all right. So, get some water, let's get started on our circuit. Our circuit today is gonna consist of 6 exercises. Every exercise is intentionally planned. Each exercise uses a combination of large muscle groups, and each exercise is focusing and addressing a common symptom of Parkinson's disease. You may not have any of these symptoms, you may have some of them, you may have all of them. Either way, whether you have them or don't, it's a really good practice to focus on these large muscle groups and to focus on these motions. Research has shown that using and practicing and repetitive motion improves the brain, improves those that ability to do those motions. So let's get started. Our first exercise is a front lunge with a cross lunge, a front cross lunge. This is on this exercise, you're going to need or want your weights. You don't have to use your weights, but you can. So what we're going to do is start with the right leg. The right leg comes forward into a lunge, 90 degrees in both legs. Let's add an opposite bicep curl. So we're using opposites here. And then back, and then we're going to do a front cross lunge, which is just crossing and curling. And then we come back, and then we're going to use the other side. Left leg comes forward with the right arm, curl. And then we're going to cross in front, cross. So we're still using opposites. So front and cross, front and cross. That's our first exercise. We're going to be doing that for a timed 1 minute. You'll see our clock on top. Here we go. Big step forward, big cross in front. Big step forward, cross in front. Stay at your pace, don't go at mine. Speed this up if you want to. Slow it down if you need to. Make sure that chair or a wall is near you for safety. We're working glutes, hamstrings, mostly legs, and of course our bicep curl. Try not to swing or throw your arms. Try to make everything very purposeful. And done. Good job. All right, that's our first exercise in our series. Our next exercise, you're going to use those weights again. This is an upper body exercise, but we're going to throw in some legs also. This is a curl and a press. Here it is, curl and a press. A curl. Elbows stay in front of you, elbows don't move, you bend at the elbow, curl to your shoulders. Rotate those arms and reach directly overhead, not in front, directly overhead. Then we come back down, rotate and down. Then we're going to do a curl and a fly. Curl is here again, but the fly, we're going to lift those elbows out to the side. Try not to extend your arms to a full extension, soft, keep them soft and round, right here. And then we bring it back in and down. Curl and press. Curl and fly. And to make it just a little more fun, we're going to do that on alternating knees. Curl and press. Curl and fly. Make sure you've got that chair nearby or a wall for safety. Let's give that a shot. 60 seconds. Come on and join me. Working all upper body. Biceps, shoulders. Biceps and shoulders. Different angles. Working the shoulders. This is an important upper body motion. Adding resistance to make it more fun and hard. Working on balance as well. Standing all your weight on one foot. There's our time. Good job. All right, so that's our upper body. We're going to move our next exercise. is all about your glutes. It's all about strengthening your legs, your the front and back of your leg. I'm going to ask you to sit on that chair if you have that chair nearby. You're going to do a chair squat. If you don't have a chair, you're going to do a squat, but I want you to think about sitting in that invisible chair as if you were in a chair. Your legs are at 90, feet are in front of you, slightly, not quite at 11 and 1 o'clock, but slightly out, not directly in front at 12. Hands are here. Give you some. You're going to come up, and then we're going to add a rotation. You're going to just turn and look over one shoulder, come back down, make sure that you're in position, have a seat, stand up, rotate the other way. If you don't have a chair, and just do this without a chair, or you feel like you've got your form down, you're going to sit as low as you can, 90 degree angles if you can. Try not to go below. Come up and rotate, sit down, and rotate. So we're working large muscles in your legs, but we're also adding some abdominal work as well. All right, find your position. We're going to put our music on and our timer. Let's go. If you need your hands to help you, put them on your thigh. That's not cheating. That's strengthening, slowly learning to get your arms and your body in the right position. Using your hands to help you pushes and strengthens the legs also. That's not cheating. It will also keep you safe. I like to keep my arms in front. It helps me with the balance. When you stand, make sure you're squeezing your glutes right here, standing tall so you're not bending forward or back. You're standing totally erect. Just a few more seconds. Here we go. All right, how'd we do? Feeling those legs moving? Good for you. All right, we're going to get the chair out of the way for our next exercise, or actually you can use it. We're going to be doing a plank knee tap, or some people call it a bear to plank. Either way, we're going to start off on the floor in a plank position. You can do this on your knees or your hands. Elbows or your hands. Here's a low plank, and you're going to bend those knees and tap. That's fine. That's great. You can bring it to a high plank. Hands are directly underneath your shoulders. Body is on long plank. Make sure your hips are tucked underneath you. Make sure your shoulder blades are pushing down towards your hips. Your abs are tight. You can bend both knees to a bear position and then up. Modification, one knee at a time. Still get plenty of work here. I promise you're going to feel that. If that plank position is too hard to hold for a minute, don't worry, I have an answer for you. We're going to use the chair in the same position, plank position, right here, one knee at a time, both knees. Make sure you're in that diagonal. That's the only thing. You don't want to be upside down or too low, okay? I'm going to start on the floor, see how I do. We're going to put our timer on, our 1 minute. This is a core exercise. We're strengthening all these muscles in the front of your body. So here we go. Knee at a time, if that works for you. Both knees. This is a slow and controlled exercise. Make sure you're really pulling everything in. Make sure you're tightening everything. Make sure your body is long and lean. An added benefit of this, you're going to feel maybe a little strengthening, a little workout in those quadriceps. Yes, they're working, but it's really primarily, if you're doing it properly, it's really core. I'm feeling this right in the tummy. Make sure your shoulders are directly over your hands. And there it is. All right, getting up off the floor. It's really important that we do this safely and you get into the habit of doing it safely because you may need this someday later. So you want to take your stronger leg, that's usually your right leg, your more dominant leg. Leg in front, hand on your thigh. Lift yourself up using your body strength. Keep your head above your chest. All right, so that's our Fourth exercise, our next exercise is a lateral squat. Lateral meaning we're going sideways. I'm going to grab my weights for this. You don't have to, you can grab yours as well. Holding on, we're going to take a nice large wide step lateral. The leg that's in the middle stays straight. The leg that's on the side bends, and I'm going to reach toward the floor. Flat back, not round back. Flat, and then I'm going to come back up to center. And I'm going to do a press. I'm using those shoulders again. I'm also using my upper back. So when you reach for that press, think about using your shoulder blades pulling down. Then we go to the other side. Straight leg, bent leg toward the floor, in reach. A modification for this would be not, well, without weights, but just going right here to one side, bent, straight, not going quite as low, that's fine. Still working both legs, still working everything you need to. Come up, full extension, the extension is important. Bend, full extension. Please stay safe, stay at your level. Here we go. How we doing? All right, stay with it. These feel good, don't they? All right. Nice job. We have one more exercise to do, and this is our cardio exercise. This is just about kicking it up, getting our heart rate up. There's no real amount of form that's necessary, except you want to make sure that you're not throwing your body around. I'm going to invite you to join me and do a run and a mountain climber. What I mean by that is I'm going to bring my chair over because I'm going to do it modified, but a run and a mountain climber. So what I'm going to do is run for about 10 runs, go right down here into a mountain climber and run about 10 of those. Bring it back in, run, down, mountain climber. You can do this here. Come on down to the floor, run it out, bring it back up, and run it out. That's up to you. You stay at your pace. If this exercise doesn't work for you, do what does work for you. Do some jumping jacks, just running in place, add some weights. Do whatever it is that you can do. We got 1 minute to get that heart rate up. This is about bringing oxygen and blood to the brain, forcing the body to move quickly. Let's go. Joining me? How are you doing your own? Bring those knees all the way into your chest. If you're doing those mountain climbers, get those legs moving. Try not to be upside down. Oh my goodness. Once again, you don't want to just stop. Please walk it around your room. Grab your water. Get your heart rate down. Best way to slow your heart rate is to breathe slower. Force yourself to breathe slower. So let's take a deep breath together. And exhale. Great way of learning to slow your heart rate down safely. You never want to just stop. All right, so great, that was our first circuit, first round. Good for you. So now you know all six exercises, you know what we're doing, you know the form, you know what works best for you, a modified or full out, that's fine. We're gonna do all of those exercises again, each for a minute. This time, I want you to focus on the benefit of how it will benefit your Parkinson's. And each one of these has a real specific benefit. Our first exercise is all about gait, really working on gait and balance, because that's what gait is really works on also. So we're going to take one leg, and instead of just taking that leg in front, I want you to think about really extending that leg, because very often Parkinson's will force you to take smaller steps. So a nice big step, using your opposite arm, that's the opposite, forcing contralateral motions, which is important for walking, using opposites that will improve your balance. And then we're coming back, and then you're going to cross that midline. So yes, we're working glutes, but we're also working on gait and crossing that midline. Cross it right here. All right, so we're going to put our music back on. We're going to put our timer back on. We're going to do this for one full minute. But not only are you thinking about your quads and your glutes and your biceps, I want you to really think about taking those long, wide steps for Parkinson's. Here we go. And opposite. So I'm forcing myself to remind myself to use those opposites. I'm actually going a little slower than I would if I was just doing this for my legs. I'm doing this a little slower to retrain my brain to reinforce those motions. Whoops, that was wrong. Nice big wide steps. Safe. All right, good. Next exercise, again, we're going to stay with these weights. You can do this standing or seated, your choice. Also, just for balance, because we are doing them on one leg. The benefit for Parkinson's in this particular exercise is upper body strength, which is necessary to prevent yourself from falls, to save yourself if you do fall. You have the strength to help yourself up. It's also a really good posture exercise because we're working on shoulders, pushing those shoulders back, opening up the chest. So we're standing on one leg, balance, and we're reaching up. Once again, shoulder blades down, arms up, all about your posture. And then we're working on both sides, front and back of shoulder, keeping you nice and erect, strong body. All right, here we go. Try to focus on those two things, in addition to strengthening your arms. Balance. Good. And you never have to lift that knee all the way up. Right here, on your toe. Just putting all your weight on one foot on your toe will also work on balance. So you can do it and still stay safe if standing on one leg is not working for you. Pull your belly in, stand nice and tall. Try not to swing your arms, try to control it and place them. All right, we're on our last few. Okay, I lost it just at the very end. All right, the next exercise is the chair squat. This is all about, once again, we're still working on balance, but I threw this rotation in. So we're not just working on strength of legs, which are really important for gait and for balance, really important. I threw in the rotation because a common symptom of Parkinson's is rigidity, being very rigid, not a more fluid motion. So we're gonna strengthen those legs, but then we're gonna a nice fluid motion. Rotate instead of a stiff. Take those shoulders and keep your hips in place. Use your trunk, all right? So think about doing that in addition to, of course, the squatting. Make sure your hips are behind you when you squat, being good to your knees. If your knees are in front of your toes, you're putting your knees at risk, and you may not feel this tomorrow, but you may feel this sometime in the future. So stay safe right now. Here we go. Big swing. Sit down, stand up. big swing. Try to keep your hips in front. So you're really rotating from the trunk. Separating your upper and lower body so you're not working so rigidly. And of course, you're pushing on your heels, strengthening your legs. Try not to go too fast on these. You don't want to wrench your back. You want to strengthen your obliques without hurting yourself. I like having that chair behind me. It forces me to be in position, forces me to really push on my heels, right? Almost done, here we go. All right, nice, good. Were you able to do a little more now that you know why you're doing it? I think it really helps to understand the benefits and what you will get out of it. The next exercise is our plank knee tap. This is all about balance. We are strengthening the core right here. This is really where a lot of balance comes from. The stronger your core is, the better able you are to break a fall. This is really where your strength comes from. So we want to strengthen the core. And as I said, you'll still also feel it in your quadriceps. So I want you to think about tucking your hips underneath you. So you're forcing that abdominal, triggering those abdominal muscles to be working. And then one knee or both knees at a time will also trigger those muscles, forcing them in and out. All right, let's hit the floor. Think about balance. Shoulders over the hands. Let's move away from the table. Here we go. And I like to do these really slow, so I really muscle through them. Stay at your pace. If you go a little too quick, you're just going to feel, you're going to burn out those quads. You're just going to feel it in your quads. If you go slow, more controlled, you can really feel those abs working. Make sure that your arms are directly underneath you. Form is everything in this particular exercise. Stay in a long, strong diagonal. Off the chair is fine. Even the wall. Pull tight, we're almost done. And great, you can release your lower back by sitting back into a child's pose just for a second. Take your stronger leg in front. Hands on, head above your chest. Watch out for this. Lift yourselves up because we're going right into our lateral squat tap. This is about direction change. People lose their balance when they change their direction. Going forward very often is easy, but the minute you change your direction, either because you're twisting or just by moving in the other direction, it increases your risk of falling, of losing your balance. So you want to practice that, stepping, planting your feet on the ground, stepping nice and strong. The second part of that is that lift over your head, and that once again is all about posture. And I want you to go from a down position to a standing. Feel the difference between leaning and standing tall. Be aware of where your body is. Open up your chest. Be aware of your posture. The more you're aware of it, the more it becomes second nature to you. So let's add our weights if you want to. Otherwise, find your position. Here we go. Nice big step. Open up the chest. Big step. Find your balance. Open up the chest. We're also reinforcing, just so you know, and I just realized, we're also reinforcing that contralateral motion, that right going to left, left going to right, reinforcing that natural walking, natural gait, reminding your body to move opposites together. Again, balance. Pull your belly tight on the stand. And done. All right. My favorite part is the next one. The next exercise is the cardio. We're going to up that tempo. You're going to take it to a run and a mountain climber. You can run the whole time. You can mountain climber the whole time. You can do jumping jacks. You can do whatever it is you want to do. Get your heart rate up. 1 minute. Are you ready? Let's go. We're about halfway through. Come on, stay with it. Maybe now that you know what it feels like, maybe you can kick it up a little more now, because we only have a few more seconds. So let's go. Let's bring it up a little more, okay? Come on. Whew. All right. Run it out. Almost done. We're going to get that heart rate down, remember. And let me get that chair out of the way. Walk, 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 walk. Don't stop. Get that heart rate down, deep breaths in and out. When you feel a little more comfortable, please grab some water. We have one more round to go. Six exercises, 1 minute apiece. This is the best part. This last round is all about cognitive. I'm going to ask you to do all six exercises exactly as we just did them, with intention, thinking about form and its positive effects for Parkinson's. And then I'm going to also ask you to think about something completely different than what we're doing, to stimulate the brain even more. First exercise is our front lunge with the curl. It's carnival season. And when I mean carnival, I don't mean carnival. I mean just carnivals are going all over the country. It's fall, it's nice, it's weather's nicer. So you see these kind of pop-up carnivals. Let's think of every time you come down, or just a list as you're doing it for the 1 minute, think of things that you see at a carnival, all right? And that could be anything from rides to food to people, things you see at a carnival. Are you ready? I'm going to grab my weights. Here we go. Don't forget to cross with opposites. Big step. I know those first few seconds are easy to come up with carnival things, but it's starting to get a little harder, isn't it? And, all right. Catch your breath, hold on to those weights. We're moving on to the upper body curl and fly. Curl and press, curl and fly. On one leg if you can. This time I want you to think of every time you move, whether it's a curl, a fly, or a press, think about things that people put on their head. I'm not going to say anything more. Just things that people put on their head. Okay? Here we go. Don't forget, this is all about shoulders and upper back, besides your arms. So concentrate. Control it. Try not to swing those arms. Pull your belly tight for balance. Almost done. Hopefully you were able to fill a minute of things that you put on your head. The next exercises are squat and rotation. I'm going to pull my chair over. Right, let's think of something this time. Famous athletes. How about that one? Famous athletes. Male, female, I don't care what. I don't care what sport it is. We happen to have a famous athlete here at our working for Power for Parkinson's. Our friend Garden is a pole vaulter, and an accomplished pole vaulter at that. So, Garden is your first one. You can think of some others as we do this. Legs are wide, not too wide. Hip distance apart. Pushing on those heels. Let's get going. You come up, think of another one. Tonight at dinner, you'll come up with a million of them, but right now, under pressure, don't forget to rotate though. Come up, don't let your hips pull you up. Let your legs pull you up. So you're not swinging to get up, you're lifting. This one goes by pretty quick for me. How about you? Maybe filling it with famous athletes may slow it down a little. Okay, our next exercise. We're going to hit the floor for our ab exercise, for our work on balance, strengthening our abs, working on that six pack. And of course, balance. Now, when we're on the floor, on your chair, on the wall, whatever, each time you bend one knee or both knees, I want you to think of tools that you would commonly find in a toolbox. This should be fairly easy for some of you, considering my toolbox consists of a nail file and a Band-Aid. It's a little more difficult, but let's see how you do. So let's hit the floor, put on our timer and our music, and go. Things in a toolbox. Pull your belly tight, tuck those hips underneath you, open up your shoulders, push your shoulder blades toward your heels. A lot to remember. Stay in a long line. I'm really concentrating on keeping my body controlled, contracted, firm, strong. I'm lengthening those legs. Also important for range of motion, being aware of where your body is. Try to lengthen those legs for range of motion. While you're thinking of things in the toolbox. Good. All right. Releasing your lower back for a second if you need it. One leg in front. Lift yourself up. We're going to go to those lateral squats with the press. The press is all about posture. The lateral squats is all about gait, crossing that midline, using opposites. Now, my favorite one of all, this time I want you to count by 14. Okay? 14 and then whatever follows after that. Not my strength. But it may be yours. All right, so let's put on our music and our timer. We're going to count by 14 every time you go to, every time you do a motion. So out, up, out, up. Ready? Here we go. Concentrate on your motions. Try not to go too fast so that you're really doing your motions intentionally. Thank you. good. How'd we go? Were you able to go past 14? All right, the last exercise, we're going to kick it out. This is it, our last exercise of our last round. We're doing our cardio round. Let's put that music on. Nice and fast, just move it. There's nothing to think about except getting your heart rate up. Let's get going. Here we go. Just in the nick of time. I was not gonna make it. Okay, walk it off, wipe it off, get that heart rate down. How'd we do? Good for you, you made it all three rounds, six exercises, working on everything. We worked, I don't think we missed a large muscle group. We worked chest, we worked shoulders, both front, side, and back. We worked biceps, triceps on those planks. We got it all done. Core, obliques, all that rotation, we got it all done. So good for you, nice work, full body exercise. And all done in, 45 minutes, so here we go. All right, so let's cool it down. I'm gonna use my chair to cool down. You can do this on the floor or on your own. Start off with just stretching out our quadriceps. You can do this by going into a lunge position, dropping that back knee and leaning just gently to lengthen this muscle. Try not to make this strength training by using your glutes. Try to lengthen it by using this muscle. Another way, a way I prefer, is by grabbing hold of that toe and pulling back. If you can grab hold of that toe standing nice and tall, make sure that knee, watch my knee. This is not exactly the best place to put it. Let's put that knee right next to the other knee. Let's push it slightly behind the other knee. By doing so, you can really feel the muscles that we're intending to, that front, the quadricep, the front of your muscle. I want to try to open up that hip instead of bending at the hip. Instead of bending there, you want to open it up nice and big. And just hold here. All this yapping I've done has at least taken 10 or 15 seconds. So that's what we're looking for. Anything less than 15 seconds is really not as beneficial. Let's switch legs. Let's go to the other side. I'm going to grab hold of that leg on this side. Grab hold of my toe or my ankle and pull it back. Try to make that knee face the floor. Try to get it behind the other knee while standing tall, lengthening this right here, your flexor. Lengthen that muscle, that's important. That will help you with that that quadricep stretch. Standing nice and tall, deep breath in. Slow the heart rate and go out. Good, all right. Staying right where we are, I'm gonna take your right leg directly in front. I'm gonna ask you to put your hands on your hips. Okay, hands on your hips. Look down and make sure that your hands are even. One hip is not in front. That's why your hands are on your hips. I want you to see where your hips are. I'm going to show you just a slightly different way. Not better, not worse, just a different way of doing a hamstring stretch. So you've got your right heel in front. Your left leg is bent. You're going to lean forward with both hips even instead of taking that right hip and swinging it forward. Keep both hips even and just gently lean forward. When your hips are even, you can release them and put them on your thighs and hold it right here. Some of you may like to drop that toe. That's fine. That will give you just a slightly different stretch, but hold it here. Nice and easy. Deep breath in and long exhale out. Let's do that one more time. Deep inhale and exhale. Good, roll up gently, roll up. You never want to just jump out of a stretch. Let's switch legs. Now you're going to take that left leg directly in front, heel down, toe up. Your right leg is gently, you're going to push your hips back. Hands on your hips to make sure that they are even, that left hip is not full of pushing in front. Push them evenly behind. Stretch forward with your chest leading. Try not to round that back out. Once your hips are in place and you're leaning into it, you can drop your hands to your thighs, never on the kneecaps. That's not a great place to put them. And stay right here. Deep breath in. Drop that toe if you'd like. Again, just change the stretch just gently. Inhale and exhale. Deep inhale and exhale. Great job. Gently roll up. I'm going to have a seat. You can do this next stretch on the floor. This is called the number four stretch because you're going to make your legs into a number four. So one leg is straight. I'm going to take my right leg from the ankle on to the thigh, and leg is out to the side, so we've got a number four. Backwards or forward, it's a four or a P, right? So just stay right here. Abdominals are pulled in, shoulders are nice and tall. You can increase the intensity by leaning into it. If this is enough for you, just stay right here. You're gonna feel a nice stretch in that glute. We did do a lot of glutes today. We did it in the front cross lunge, we did it in the chair squats, and we did it in the lateral squats and press. So we did a lot. You want to make sure that you're releasing and relaxing those muscles as well. Deep breath in and out. Good. Let's drop that leg gently, carefully, and switch. By the way, if you can't get that leg over your thigh, right here is fine. Even out on the ankle is also a great option. As long as that knee is out to the side, you're engaging your glute. So that's all we want to do, engage the glute, lengthen that muscle. So I'm going to bring that leg directly in front. I'm going to bring in my nice deep breath in. And again, if you want to increase the intensity of this stretch, you can lean into it. Otherwise, sitting tall is fine if you're feeling it in your glute. Deep breath in and out. Remember, we're all attached differently, and our flexibility and muscle is different on everyone. So there is not necessarily a good or bad way. There's just the way that works for you, which is always the best way. Deep breath in and out. All right. I'm going to release my lower back from doing those planks and the squats. So I'm going to ask you to lean gently into it, arms in front, and stretch forward. I'm going to ask you not to round out and go toward your toes. That can be a little too stressful for some of you. So I'm going to ask you just to gently just reach forward. You're going to feel a nice stretch right here in that lower back. Gentle stretch. That rotation may also affect some of you. So you want to make sure that we're lengthening and stretching those muscles. Right from here, as we're pulling in, as we talk about that rotation, let's just gently stretch one arm slightly over to the side, so we're lengthening that side of the body, the opposite side, the side that we're stretching from. We're working on obliques, lower back, and then come back to center, pushing forward just gently, and let's go to the other side. And you never want to strain or stress. If you're feeling anything that doesn't feel right, please don't do it. Please release it, come back a little further, do what works for you. All right, and back to center. Let's bring those arms fully overhead. I'm going to stand for our last few stretches and get my chair out of the way. So we're standing. You can stay seated, working on abdominal muscles. Lengthen those muscles by pulling your belly button in, tucking your tailbone underneath you, really lengthening and feeling those arms. Now, we did do a lot of upper back exercise today with all those presses. So I'm going to ask you to lift that upper back, drop your chin, lift it nice and high, open it up, deep breath in and out. Biceps from all those curls, palms are up. Reach behind you and hold it right here. Let's all work on a vocal strength while we're stretching out our biceps and chest and shoulder. Let's just say the word ah for about 10 or 15 seconds together. Good, all right, arms directly up above. Holding that note has been shown that is a really great way of strengthening vocal power. It's a great thing to do just throughout the day as you're, I don't know, watching TV, anything, you're washing your face. Whatever you do during the day, you have 15 seconds to work on just holding a note. It can be very, very beneficial for vocal strength. So we have finished our exercise for today. We are done. Let's give a big yay because we are done and we worked hard and did a great job together. Yay! finishing with a smile. Thank you so much for joining me today. We do have a new video every second Saturday of the month, so I will see you in a month. Stay safe, stay strong. I'll see you next time.